principle of electrophoresis. Electrophoresis is a migration of charged particle under the influence of an electric field. When potential difference voltage is applied across electrode, it generates potential gradient E, which is applied voltage V divided by distance d between the electrode. When this potential gradient E is applied, the force on a molecule bearing a charge of q coulombs is eq newtons. It is this force that drives a charged molecule towards an electrode. However, there is a frictional resistance that retards the movement of a charged molecule. This frictional force is a measure of hydrodynamic size of molecule, shape of molecule, pore size of a medium in which electrophoresis is taking place, and viscosity of a buffer. Velocity of a charged molecule in electric field is therefore given by the equation as shown here. Electrophoresis is also expressed as the electrophoretic mobility of an ion, which is a ratio of velocity of an ion to the field strength as shown in the figure. When potential difference is applied, molecule with different overall charge will begin to separate owing to the different electrophoretic mobility. Even molecule with similar charge will begin to separate if they have a different molecular size, since they will experience different frictional force. In addition to charge of a molecule, difference in the molecular size and hence frictional resistance plays an important role in the separation. The current in the solution between electrophoresis is conducted mainly by the buffer ions, a small proportion being conducted by the sample ions. Ohm's law expresses relationship between current and voltage and resistance, that is as shown in the figure. Though electrophoretic separation can be accelerated by increasing applied voltage, which would result in the corresponding increase in the flowing current, however, the applied high voltage may generate a lot of heat. It is expressed in terms of power, that is W, watts, generated in the medium is given by equation as shown in the figure. Most of the power generated is dissipated as a heat. Heating of electrophoresis medium has following effect during the process. For instance, increased rate of diffusion of sample and buffer ions can lead to broadening of the separated sample. Formation of convection current, which leads to mixing of a separated sample. Thermal instability of a sample that is rather sensitive to heat. This may include denaturation of a protein, for example, loss of enzymatic activity. Decrease of buffer viscosity, hence reduction in the resistance of the medium, eventually affecting the overall electrophoretic process. Support media. Support media cuts. There are different advantages of using support media. For example, support media cuts down the convection current and diffusion so that separated components remain as a sharp zone. It should be relatively inert. Its exact composition, even small amount of charges on it, would also affect the rate of migration of molecule in different ways. Adsorption denotes the retention of a sample molecule by supporting media, as in adsorption chromatography. Adsorption reduces both rate and resolution of a compound, causing trailing of a band. Electroendoosmosis is another parameter, which is dissociable cation of supporting media and associated water molecule migrate towards the cathode. That results in net movement of a liquid through the gel pores towards the cathode. During the electrophoresis, movement of a sample in the direction of anode, therefore cathodal EEO in opposite direction, disrupts the separation of biomolecule by internal convection. Electrophoresis is done from negative to positive terminal. Another property is molecular sieving. This property is exhibited when gels such as agar, agarose, starch, polyacrylamide are used as a supporting media. Intervened molecular chains in such gels result in the sieve-like structure. The pore size can be increased or decreased by decreasing or increasing the gel concentration. The movement of a large molecule is retarded increasingly by decreasing the pore size. How to measure EEO, that is electroendoosmosis? Uncharged molecule urea, dextrin, sucrose, deoxyribose are used to measure EO. Blue dextrin is frequently used because it can be directly visualized. EO is measured by subjecting a mixture of dextrin and albumin in electrophoresis, then visualizing them and measure their relative distance from the origin. The amount of EO is calculated by dividing the migration of distance of neutral dextrin by the sum of the migration of a distance of dextrin and albumin. Agarose gels. Agarose is another support media which is widely used in electrophoresis process. Agarose is a linear polymer of agarobiose, disaccharide made up of D-galactose and 3,6-anhydroL-galactopyranose. The structure is shown in figure. Agarose is a type of agar made up of polysaccharides mixture isolated from certain seaweeds. Agarose gels are formed by suspending a dry agarose in aqueous buffer, then boiling a mixture until clear solution forms. This is poured and allowed to cool at room temperature to form a rigid gel. The gelling properties are attributed to both inter- and intramolecular hydrogen bonding formed between the long agarose chains. This agarose link structure gives a gel good anti-conventional property. The pore size in the gel is controlled by the initial concentration of agarose. Large pore size are formed a rigid gel. The gelling properties are attributed to both inter- and intramolecular hydrogen bonding within and between the long agarose chains. Although essentially free from charge, substitution of alternating sugar residues with carboxyl, methoxyl, pyruvate and essentially sulfate group occur to varying degree. This substitution can result in electroendoosmosis during electrophoresis as discussed above, an ionic interaction between gel and sample in all uses, both unwanted effect. Agarose is therefore sold in different purity grades based on sulfate concentration, lower sulfate content with high purity. DNA fragment of given size migrate at different rates through gel containing different concentration of agarose. There is a linear relationship between algorithm of electrophoretic mobility of DNA and gel concentration, which is shown in equation. Agarose gels are used for electrophoresis of both proteins and nucleic acid. For proteins, pore size of 1% agarose gel is used due to large relative size of protein, and it is used in flat bed isoelectric focusing where proteins are required to move unhindered in a gel matrix according to their native charge. Such large pore gels are also used to separate much larger molecules such as DNA or RNA because pore size in gel are still large enough for DNA or RNA molecule to pass through the gel. Now, however, pore size and molecular size are more comparable and frictional effect begin to play important role in separation of this molecule. Further advantage of using agarose is availability of low melting temperature agarose. What are the applications of agarose? Agarose can be used for estimation of size of DNA molecule following restriction enzyme digestion, for example in restriction mapping of cloned DNA, analysis of PCR product, that is in molecular genetic diagnosis or genetic fingerprinting, separation of restricted genomic DNA prior to sudden transfer or RNA prior to sudden transfer. Another widely used support matrices in electrophoresis is polyacrylamide gel. It is also known as PAGE, that is polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. This electrophoresis is performed in acrylamide gel, where cross-linked polyacrylamide gels are formed from polymerization of acrylamide monomer in the presence of smaller amount of N-N-methylene bisacrylamide. Bisacrylamide is cross-linking agent consisting of two acrylamide molecules linked by methylene group. PAGE and SDS PAGE is discussed in detail in another chapter in the same e-content. Native gels. What is native gel? While SDS page is most frequently used for studying proteins, method is not useful to study functional properties of protein, for example, an enzyme, because protein is denatured during the process of SDS page procedure. In native gel, polyacrylamide gel without SDS are used and proteins are not denatured prior to loading, since all proteins in the sample being analyzed carry the native charge at a pH of a gel, normally pH 8.7. Proteins separate according to different electrophoretic mobility and sleeving property of the gel. It is therefore not possible to predict the behavior of a given protein in a buffer gel, but because of a range of a different charge and size of a protein in a given protein mixture, good resolution is achieved. Enzyme of interest can be identified by incubating gel in appropriate substrate solution, such as colored product is produced at a site of enzyme. The alternative method for enzyme detection is to include substrate in agarose gel that is poured over a polyacrylamide gel and allowed to set. Diffusion and interaction of enzyme and substrate between two gels results in the color formation at a site of enzyme. Often, duplicate samples will run on the gel and gel is cut into half and one and half and one half stain for activity, other for total protein. In this way, total protein content of the sample can be analyzed and particular band corresponding to enzyme identified by reference to the activity of stain gel. Gradient gel. Gradient gel is another example of polyacrylamide gel system, where instead of running a slab gel of uniform pore size throughout, gradient gel is formed. Acrylamide concentration varies uniformly from 5% to 5% at the top of the gel to 25% acrylamide at the bottom of the gel. Gradient is formed with the help of gradient mixture and run down between the glass plates of the slab gel. Higher percentage of acrylamide is poured between glass plates first and continuous gradient of decreasing acrylamide concentration follows. Therefore, at the top of the gel, there is a large pore size, but as sample moves down through the gel, acrylamide concentration slowly decreases and pore size correspondingly increases. Gradient gel are normally run as a SDS page with a stacking gel. Therefore, there are two advantages to running gradient gel. First, much greater range of protein with molecular weight value can be separated than on fixed percent gel. In complex mixture, very low molecular weight protein travel freely through the gel to begin with and to start to resolve when they reach the smaller pore size towards the lower part of the gel. Much larger proteins, on other hand, can still enter the gel but start to separate immediately due to sleeving effect of the gel. The second advantage of gradient gel is protein with very similar molecular weight can be resolved, otherwise they cannot be resolved in fixed percentage of gel. As each protein moves through the gel, pore size becomes smaller until protein reaches its pore size limit. Pore size in gel is now too small to allow passage of a protein and protein sample stucks up at its point at sharp bend. Similar size protein but slightly lower molecular weight will be able to travel little further though gel before reaching its pore size limit at which point it forms a sharp bend. These two proteins of slightly different molecular values therefore separates as two close sharp bends, which is otherwise not possible to separate in normal SDS page. What are the advantages of gel electrophoresis? Gel electrophoresis is used in different industries and research laboratories. For example, in forensic lab, molecular biology labs, genetics, microbiology, and biochemistry. The results can be analyzed quantitatively by visualizing gel with UV and gel imaging device. Image is recorded with a computer-operated camera, and intensity of a band or spot in intensity spot of interest is measured and compared against the standard marker loaded on the same gel. The measurement and analysis are mostly done with specialized software available.